There's other breaking news we're following right now. The opinion editor of the New York Times has just resigned amid an uproar over an op-ed by Republican Senator Tom Cotton calling for military force potentially to be used against rioters in U.S. cities. CNN's Brian Stelter and Oliver Darcy are joining us right now. Brian, very dramatic development. Update our viewers.
Yeah, this is very unusual to see one of the top editors of the New York Times suddenly resign, clearly under pressure in the wake of a controversial op-ed. This came after some other embarrassing issues in his tenure as well. But James Bennet stepped down today, again, under pressure after this controversy involving GOP Senator Tom Cotton's op-ed. It was titled Send in the Troops. It argued for military resources to stop rioters in major cities. Now, the staffers of the New York Times were very angry about this op-ed. They said it was not fit for print. It was not appropriate. Editors initially defended it, but then decided that the staff was right and decided it was inappropriate. They said it was factually inaccurate, and that's why it should not have been published. The leaders expressed regret, and over the weekend, James Bennet had talks with the publisher that led him to resign. Ultimately, Wolf, this is a big fight over what is fit for print and whether there are two sides to issues like what to do about rioting.
A very significant development. And Oliver, I want to read a statement, at least part of the statement, that James Bennet has been with the New York Times for such a long time, just released, and I'll read it to you. The journalism of Times opinion has never mattered more than in this time of crisis at home and around the world, and I've been honored to be part of it. I'm so proud of the work my colleagues and I have done to focus attention on injustice and threats to freedom and to enrich debate about the right path forward by bringing new voices and ideas to Times readers. So tell us more what happened about this supposed breakdown in the editorial process leading now to James Bennet's decision to leave the New York Times.
Well, Bennet actually conceded to staffers on Friday at a town hall that he actually never even read this op-ed before and landed on the Times site. And that was a bit of a damning admission. So, I think that AG, the Sulzberger, the publisher, may have lost some confidence in his ability to run this section. But, Wolf, this is a shocking development. I'm talking to New York Times staffers who are stunned that James Bennet is leaving over this. Partly because he was considered to be one of the top candidates to take over as executive editor for the Times in a couple of years when the current executive editor retires. And so to see him forced out is really stunning. And one more thing I want to point out, too. I was talking to a Times staffer, and while this was an embarrassing debacle for the Times, this person pointed out that it has raised important discussions about race and the Times' role in society. So some good coming out of this as well, Wolf.
Yeah, they decided, the New York Times, that they posted it online, but they decided not to include it in the print edition. It was supposed to be in today's Sunday New York Times. Never made it. All right, Oliver, Brian, good work. Thanks very much. We're going to continue to stay on top of this story.